Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you always.
And with your spirit.
As we rejoice in the Word made flesh, the babe of Bethlehem who comes to earth for us, let us call to mind and confess our sins. Have mercy on us, O Lord.
For we have sinned against you.
Show us, O Lord, your mercy.
And grant us your salvation.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Proclaims salvation and tells Zion, shout with joy together, for they see the Lord face to face as he returns to Zion. Break into shouts of joy together, you ruins of Jerusalem, for the Lord is consoling his people, redeeming Jerusalem. The Lord bears his holy arm in the sight of all the nations, and all the ends of the earth shall see the salvation of our Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Thanks be to God.
In the beginning was the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things came to be. Not one thing had its being but through him. All that came to be had life in him, and that life was the light of men. A light shines in the dark, a light that darkness could not overpower. A man came sent by God. His name was John. He came as a witness to speak for the light, so that everyone might believe through him. He was not the light, only a witness to speak for the light. The Word was the true light that enlightens all men, and he was coming into the world. He was in the world that had its being through him, and the world did not know him. He came to his own domain, and to his own people did not accept him. But to all who did accept him, he gave power to become children of God. To all who believe in the name of him who was born, not out of human stock or out of the flesh or will of man, but of God himself. The Word was made flesh. He lived among us and we saw his glory, the glory that is his as the only Son of the Father, full of grace and truth. John appears as his witness. He proclaims, "This is the one of whom I said, he who comes after me ranks before me, because he existed before me." Indeed, from his fullness we have, all of us receive, yes, grace in return for grace. Since through the law was given through Moses, grace and truth have come through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God. It is the only Son who is nearest to the Father's heart, who has made him known.
My Gospel of the Lord.
Father's side has revealed him. So we have received that fullness today, grace heaped upon grace. On this Christmas day, we can reflect on that joy that comes to us, even in the midst of sorrow and suffering and doubt, when we place all our hope in the babe of Bethlehem. We can look at our lives and see blessing. Jesus has shown us the true face of God, and that face is love and mercy. And declare our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored by the Lord God, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Rejoicing in the Word made flesh, let us make our prayers to our Heavenly Father.
Let the message of Christ in all its fullness find a home in you. In this season of Christmas, we thank our God for the gift of Jesus. Today, we open ourselves to God's Word, teaching us how to live as children of God in families of love, for respect and acceptance in families. We pray for all members of our families. May parents and children respect and honour one another for their lives and their gifts. May we care for our parents in times of need and love them as the Lord loves us. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For forgiveness and love in family life. All families are blessed by God. For forgiveness, patience and gentleness. May we be gentle in our families, especially at this time of Christmas. Accepting one another as the Lord accepts us. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For strength to live by the gospel. The Holy Family journeyed to Egypt, persecuted by those who feared the good news. May we be strong in witnessing to the truth and resolute in living the message of the gospel. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For an openness to God's purposes, Joseph received the news of God's purposes in a dream. May we be open to the promptings of the Spirit, ready to respond to the call of the gospel as the faithful disciples of Jesus. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
God of the promises, we bring before you the needs of families. Bless our families and help us to be faithful to the teaching of your Son. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us commend one another and all for whom we have prayed for the intercession of all the saints, especially as we ask for the prayers of Our Lady, as we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and the blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Lord our God, hear these and all our prayers which we make through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Thank you.
brothers and sisters, that this my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Make acceptable, O Lord, our oblation on this solemn day when you manifested the reconciliation that makes us holy and pleasing in your sight, and inaugurated for us the fullness of divine worship through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation. Giving thanks as you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis the Pope, Justin our Archbishop, and Jonathan our Bishop of all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glory for you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
custom, please do come up for a blessing. And if you'd like to come for a blessing, then please bring the booklet with you to indicate this.
Thank you.
find us a glass of something nice and fizzy afterwards. I want to say some thank yous for everybody who got the church ready and made it look so beautiful, and for the Schola, for all the music and the hard work that they have to do. So thank you very much for that, and I hope you'll have a lovely rest of the day. Now, has anybody got any presents to show me that they've brought along? Yeah? No? Oh, right, come on. Denon, what have you brought? I'm not even going to say what I'm thinking. So if anybody needs a spare set after Christmas, actually, from the amount of sweets that I had in the stocking this morning, I think I'll probably need those after Christmas. And what's this? This is very special. This is lovely. Talking photo album. So it's where is it? Where's the one? Let's see if we can find it. Yeah, I'm going to play this one because I'm going to embarrass Charlotte because she's recorded this and now doesn't know how to unrecord it. Lovely, thank you. Anybody else have any nice things? No, not yet. Nobody opened their presents. Oh, for goodness sake, I opened mine after midnight mass last night.
Did you get one?
What did I get? Diabetes, rotten teeth, I think, from the amount of alcoholism, yes. Socks. Socks, actually, yes. I mean, you know, black socks, always handy for them. What? Lego. Yes. No, I didn't get the Doctor Who Lego, but I'll be looking in the January sale for that, definitely. No, I didn't get the Pablo Leopold one either, but I'll be looking for that in the sales. Yes, and cardigan. Always good to have a cardi, especially this time of year. Well, because you've all had such boring presents. Have you all been getting presents this morning yet? Yeah? What do you have? Anything nice?
First box.
Ooh, very nice. Tablet, Android tablet. Very nice. Have you got more presents to open later? I expect having such a good. Oh, Charlotte, Tori, what did you get? I think think we'd better stand and ask for God's blessing.
My Lord be with you. Blessing of Almighty God.